What's happening here? Where am I?
The greenhouse effect is going to lead to a global catastrophe.
Greenhouse effect is a matter of real concern.
Seven Suzuki speaking for ECHO, the Environmental Children's Organization. We're a group of 12 and 13-year-olds trying to make a difference. Vanessa Setti, Morgan Geisler, Michelle Quigg, and me. We've raised all the money to come here ourselves, to come 5,000 miles to tell you adults you must change your ways. Coming up here today, I have no hidden agenda. I am fighting for my future. Losing my future is not like losing an election or a few points on the stock market. I am here to speak for all generations to come. I am here to speak on behalf of the starving children around the world whose cries go unheard. I am here to speak for the countless animals dying across this planet because they have nowhere left to go. I am afraid to go out in the sun now because of the holes in our ozone. I am afraid to breathe the air because I don't know what chemicals are in it. I used to go fishing in Vancouver, my home, with my dad, until just a few years ago we found the fish full of cancers. And now we hear of animals and plants going extinct, every day vanishing forever. In my life, I have dreamt of seeing great herds of wild animals, jungles and rainforests full of birds and butterflies, but now I wonder if they will even exist for my children to see.
Concentrations of greenhouse gases in the atmosphere are at their highest levels in more than 200,000 years. If the trend does not change, scientists expect the seas to rise 2 feet or more over the next century. Island chains such as the Maldives will disappear from the map unless we reverse the predictions. Thank you very much.
In August of 2003, the worst heat wave in Europe's recorded history descended upon the continent. A high-pressure dome of air suffocated Western Europe for a month, creating record high temperatures in Germany, England, Switzerland, and France, countries that have little commercial or residential air conditioning.
To have air conditioning is something that's sort of seen as an unnecessary luxury. Most European houses just don't have it. You open the window and that's it.
It just built up over the summer and people were hot and they never got any relief. They saw triple digit temperatures in places that they'd never saw before, and they didn't get a break when they went to bed at night.
The unrelenting heat produced Europe's worst natural disaster in 50 years, with wide-ranging crop losses, increased glacier melting in Switzerland, and rampaging forest fires in Portugal that destroyed 10% of her forests. But by far, the worst impact was the death toll, estimated at between 35 to 50,000.
It's a little hard to understand how that many people died.
The people that get hit hardest in a heat wave like this are obviously the elderly, children, and especially elderly and children among the poor, to find themselves trapped in an oven that they can't escape from.
The lesson is, even today's nasty climate events, which are bound to get worse, are things that we really have a lot of trouble handling.